Season 4 of Vanguard brought our very first round-based experience to the zombies mode in the form of Shi No Numa, aka the Swamp of Death. This isn't the first time that we've seen Shi No Numa. In fact, it's been in the game since the launch, but it was more of an objective area. Everything was pretty much closed off, so you didn't have full access to the entire map. This time around, we have a bunch of different locations, including the original storage hut, comm room, doctor's quarters, fishing hut, and a brand new location called the dig site, where the artifact of Syraxis was originally found. Now, there is a huge story element to this one, but I'm going to keep this review spoiler free. I'm not going to talk about the Easter egg steps. I will discuss one part of it, but that's simply because I want to talk a little bit about the Wonder Waffa DG2. But to keep it short and sweet for those of you that like to know exactly how I feel about this map, it's the first time since the release of Vanguard Zombies that I've actually found myself playing it more than an hour, that I've actually been compelled to come back and play it multiple times. And it's also the first time that I said, I can't wait to jump back in and play again. So in essence, I freaking love this map. I think the team at Treyarch completely knocked it out of the park. From the graphic fidelity to the way the map looks to the eerie nature of different locations to how tight the corridors can get. I think the only thing that I don't like is Zabella because she spawns in so often. But other than that, the map is honestly pretty damn fun. So that's the short and sweet of it. Let's talk a little bit more about what makes this map great, at least to me personally. You got to remember, this is our first reintroduction to the round-based experience. Vanguard has had round-based kind of through the form of an objective, but it wasn't round-based. It didn't feel like round-based. It just wasn't that good. This time around, it's changed quite a bit. It's the classic Call of Duty zombie feel that you come to expect, except it has some new twists and turns with it because we have our artifacts that we can upgrade via the hearts that we collect, and we also have our different types of covenants that we're able to get, which you can completely customize throughout the game depending on what you're trying to upgrade and what type of weapon you're going to be using, what type of playstyle you're using, and that's great. Now, this is originally something that I thought was really brilliant about the objective mode as well, because as you complete objectives and you go into the higher rounds, those covenants can really, really help you, except it got really annoying doing the same two or three objectives over and 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 over again. It just wasn't that fun. And I know it sounds really ironic when I say that, because the point of zombies has always been just kind of like running them around in circles and just trying to survive to the next round, but there's just something about that that wasn't captured in the objective mode. It's really, really hard to explain, but if you're a zombies player and you've been around for a very long time, you know exactly what I'm talking about. So in this round-based experience, every three rounds, you're going to earn a sacrificial heart, which you'll be able to get, you know, like an upgrade to your covenant, or you'll be able to upgrade your artifact. And I really think that it meshes quite well with what Treyarch's doing in round-based and how they set it up this time around. Perks are still acting very similar as well. You can buy them multiple times. You can get them for free for the very first time. And perks will spawn in at every single one of the locations that you go randomly, just like the original Shi No Numa. I really, really enjoy how much emphasis they put on the DG2 as well. Bringing back that wonder weapon is something that I don't think anyone really expected them to do. This isn't so straightforward, just grabbing a couple of parts and putting it together at a build table. You need to follow somewhat of a story, and there is a way to power up specific pieces of this device in order to build it yourself. Otherwise, if you didn't want to build it at the crafting table, you can actually get it from the mystery box after round 10, but I haven't really been able to earn it yet specifically by doing that. But me personally, I think I just enjoy building it because of all the little steps, and there's like a defense step and you have to break one of the traps in order to charge up a piece. It's awesome. Like, the entire thing is just fantastic. I also like how they included Zabella to use her as a charging mechanism for this particular device, but I will say, like I mentioned earlier briefly, she is a little bit annoying, specifically because of where you need to fire in order to hurt her, just shooting her in the face, and then she becomes immune, and then you have to wait for her to come back, and it's like a three-wave thing. The Wonder Waffa can do quite a bit of damage. Like, it can actually be your main go-to weapon. And since this game is a little different in regard to being able to infinitely replenish your ammunition because enemies are still dropping things constantly, you will virtually never run out of ammunition. And by the time you do, you'll be able to just go and spend your points at an ammo crate to get a replenish if you really needed it. I love this thing, man. It's awesome. And the new location is great for training. It's just so fun to run around and like jump and dodge and slide and try to make your way out of the enemy horde. And using that DG2 to your advantage really does light up the arena, no pun intended. And I just love the fact that it's able to take down so many strong enemies. You can pack a punch it all the way up to tier 3, and of course, using those covenants and your artifacts, you'll be able to do even more damage depending on how you have it set up. In terms of difficulty, I won't say that this map is extremely hard because of all of the room you have to run. There's a lot of areas that you can make plenty of mistakes and still be fine on the other end. But there's also an Easter egg that you can do in order to activate a rampage inducer, very similar to what we saw back in Call of Duty Black Ops Cold War. The rampage inducer sends enemies into a frenzy and they'll come at you much, much faster. All you gotta do in the beginning of the game is shoot at these lanterns and you'll see this stone lift up out of the ground and you'll be able to activate it, which turns this game into a mad dash of survival. It can be quite difficult if you're not prepared. Apart from the DG2, traps have also returned. So we have our electrical traps and the flogger where you can fling zombies all the way across the map if you wanted to. I also like how there's an Easter egg associated with that as well. The entire map takes on a more, I guess you would say, sinister feeling. Out of every single iteration of Shi No Numa that we've had, this one is probably the most dark and gritty. Unless we want to talk about custom maps that have been made over the years by our community, because some of those have gotten really wild, but on an official level from Treyarch themselves, this is probably the most sinister, dark version of Shi No Numa that we've ever had. And I'm here for it because it's amazing. Now, my big question is, moving forward, what do they plan on doing map-wise? We've already had somewhat of a semi-confirmation from Treyarch that this isn't the end. They are going to continue to do round-based maps in Vanguard. And if they're able to bring it like they did here with Shi No Numa, I have no doubt in my mind that people are going to be happy about it. I'm just wondering if they're planning on doing new maps or if they're going to repurpose the maps that we already have. Like, for example, Duranfeng, it's just Red Star. But I think that they could successfully do a round-based experience there. Maybe expand the map out a little bit, give us some new locations, and still allow us to teleport to those other objective-based locations that exist in that particular hub world when you play the objective modes, except it would all be round-based. You could use the teleporters and maybe it costs a certain amount of money, or maybe you're going to be trapped there for a few rounds, or maybe something happens and you're just being sucked in by the entities that just take you there. And the reason I bring that up over, say, a brand new experience is just simply due to the fact that I probably would wager to guess that Treyarch is just strapped on time. That is seemingly what's been the problem with Vanguard through the entirety of the year. Treyarch is kind of being pulled in so many different directions, working on so many different projects, that this is one of those situations where they just didn't have the best launch because of the time they were provided, and that I can completely understand. So, moving forward, I would love to see a new experience with the same exact settings that we have here in Shi No Numa, round-based, with the artifacts and the covenants and all that stuff. But if they had to repurpose Duranfeng and Terra Maldecta to create these new round-based experiences, I think it would be totally okay, and I think that it could work out great as long as they expanded it enough, gave some new locations, and possibly, just possibly, let us visit those objective areas as well to survive or hold out there. But to wrap up this video, I think that Treyarch did an incredible job, especially with the hand that they were dealt. I think that they turned a negative into a positive with Shi No Numa, and really more so a major departure to what they were originally working on when Zombies first shipped. And now this game kind of has a little bit for everybody, because believe it or not, there's still a lot of people out there who enjoy the objective stuff they did earlier, and now there's something for round-based fans alike. So that's all I gotta say in this video, everyone. I hope you all enjoyed. If you did, do me a favor, drop a like on this video. Subscribe for more awesome videos coming every single day, and don't forget to ring that bell icon next to the subscribe button. That way YouTube will notify you every single time my videos go live. Alrighty, folks, I'll catch you on the next one. Peace.